Yo, what's up, everybody? I'm here in cheaty mode, episode 47. I got pillars in the sky. Yeah, so today we're gonna start working on the actual temple in this area because the whole city is based around it. So I'm not necessarily starting building on it, but I am planning on, or rather planning it out. So what I have right here are a couple pillars of cobblestone. I did these in creative because it would be a pain in the butt otherwise, just to mark it out, because I wanted to get a good sense of how big this thing's going to be. So things that you have to know: this thing is going to be circle based, so it's going to go like this. This space right here is approximately 60 blocks apart. I think that's a pretty good size for what we're going to go for. It's not going to be just a circle. There's going to be an entrance way out the front, and there's going to be side wings, but side wings aren't going to be huge. They're mostly going to be made to house these things. So imagine this thing will be moved over about here, and then there'll be another one on the other side. I do have the skeleton or the skulls for it. I just haven't fought the second wither yet. So it's going to be a circle, right? And the idea of it is it's going to be sitting on top of trees. So let's say that we cut down these trees right about, I want them about the same height as the houses, and maybe even lower. And that would put them at, this is a really tall tree here, so it's kind of throwing me off. I'd put us about the bottom of where this pillar is, and then I have it sticking up so that you can see where exactly it is. But that's 60, and then if we decide somewhere along the lines that we don't like the size of it, I think this gives us a good size so that we can maybe have a pathway around it. So if we want to scale down the size of the building, we bring it in a little bit and there's, you know, a pathway on the outside. So this gives us options, the freedom to go smaller. Smaller is easier than bigger. And now I'm going to show you guys how you actually build circles in Minecraft. I was actually going to show you guys in a web browser how I make these circles and where I go. And apparently all the recording softwares I have can't capture a web browser. Okay, so go to Google, search Neil Frazier. That's N-E-I-L Frazier with an S. Voxel sphere, and it should be the first link. And what's going to give you is this thing that's going to give you a three values for the size of each block coordinate, the x, y, and the z. And I'm looking at the results right now. And then it's going to ask you for a radius. So we're doing a diameter of 60, approximately. Actually 59, I guess, and it's going to ask you for a radius. So I put in 30. Now, what I should have checked is if it will do a half. So if I put 29.5, would it give me a 59? I'm not sure. I'm not sure if it'll do halves, but the way that I'm doing it, so it's going to give you all layers of a sphere, and it's gonna lay them out one layer at a time. And what I do is I go all the way down and find the middle row. That's going to be the largest one. And looking at this one, it has 10 in a straight line on the edges like this. But I don't want evens. I don't want to be building in evens, right? I want a one block on the center. So let's mark this as our center just so that we have... And the circle is going this way, right? So I'm actually going to remove. Do you see that flash? That light flashing? Whoa, that is crazy. I don't like that. So it has 10 on in a row on this side. I'm going to make it 9 because I want to be working in evens, and that's going to make my radius or my diameter 59. So I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9, and remember we are moving very fast because of that beacon, which is a little bit scary. But anyways, so then I'm going to throw up an image somewhere here of the image that I'm using so you can see. So now I'm going over 4, come in, and over 3, not including these corner pieces. These, for all I care, these could be gone. I'm just putting them there so that I can build. So after 3, I go 2 again, 1, and 2 again. So it gives you these patterns that you wouldn't really think of. You probably wouldn't think to go 2, 2, 1, 2, but mathematically, this is the closest thing to a circle that you're gonna get. And now all the trees within this circle are going to be cut down at some point, and this whole thing is gonna be resting on top of it. And now this is going to come in like this. So I'm going to work on this for a little bit, try to get it exact. The way I try to organize it, by the way, I should throw out there, is it highlights one quadrant. And so I'll do one quadrant and then I'll come over to the other side. I'll do it one quadrant at a time. It just makes it, if you think about it that way, it makes it much more organized. So let me get going on this and then I'll show you the product. And hopefully it's a size that we like. And that is what it looks like. It's a little off center. yeah, this is a pretty good size, I think. Ooh, you can see stuff over there. This is a pretty good size, I think. Not much else to talk about. We already talked about this. Pretty much covered everything before I built it. I did raise it like 3 blocks just because I felt like it needed to be there. Let's go back into survival mode and look at what else I built. This is probably going to be a really short episode because I've done most of the work. Woo! I do have feather falling, so thank goodness, because I'd have died many times. I don't know how to get up there. I had been using ender pearls, and I think that I used up my last bit. I don't have another way to get up there. Let's just try. We'll just burst through. How about that? Yeah, I started building on the houses. Last episode, if you watched it, we went over roughly the design of what this place was going to be like. And I pretty much sailed with it. Oh, gosh. I pretty much sailed with it. Oh, no. And gosh, got it. Yeah, I pretty much, for the 5th time, settled on this design, and I wanted to build a little bit and see, number one, if I could find a way to prevent leaf decay, because when you cut down right here, it wants to get rid of a bunch of these leaves. And my solution was right about here. Yeah, do I have any more leaves? I do not, so I'm gonna have to replace that on my own time. I put logs inside of them in all these corners, and then I chop it down, and then it prevents pretty much all leaf loss. It might still lose these ones on the edge. I think it lost this. There was one right here. It may have lost a couple right here. See, they're supposed to have 2 like that. So that's one thing that I found out, and luckily it did work out, because if not, then I was considering maybe having to go into creative and just filling them out, because getting leaves with shears and then making them all by hand on every single tree, I'd basically be making this entire jungle by scratch. I'm already remaking the trees, but here's the pathways. I think they look pretty good. Look at the angles on them. See how they hang. I don't know if I'm going to put these on them or what. I kind of like that it's kind of dangerous. See, different height changes mean that you're going to get different angles on these bridges. Like this one has to go up more there. That one is even on each side. This one just goes straight up. But it's not just a 45 degree angle. You can see I do start out at a lower slope and then make my way up. So the other thing theme with this place is I'm using like all kinds of woods. Here's oak, here's dark oak, jungle, spruce. I think the only one I haven't used yet is acacia, right? And I'm using all sorts of colored clay. So it's really colorful, and I really like the way that it looks. Here's another thing. I didn't put a house up there yet, but I did make a staircase. Goes up here, goes onto the roof. I like this, using the roof as part of the staircase. We have little railings here so that it's harder to walk over, and not everywhere. It's still pretty sketchy. Still a pretty sketchy deal here. And then, you know, it comes up here and there'll be another house here. And there'll probably be one right here. Actually, I've already cut out the section for it. So there's going to be another one there. So I really like that because that's going to give us lots of dimension. There's going to be houses here. Then you see them up there. So let's take a look. I think I'm done. Well, let's take a quick look at how I did these. So just kind of walk around here and you can see here's the roofs. You know, it's nothing super fancy. It's one of those quantity over quality builds. Although I do like these houses quite a bit, actually, considering how simple they are. So yeah, let's go onto the floor and give you the whole view that sort of inspired me to do this. Now that looks pretty good to me. I was talking to someone about this and they're like, I don't like how tall your trees are. You need to lower them. Can you imagine these being any closer to the ground or like 20 blocks closer to the ground? It just wouldn't look good. I like how far up they are. I'm going to have to find some sort of a way up there because I don't want to have to use ender pearls every time. They're kind of difficult to get into. So the idea is that maybe they use or they start living up there to get away from the ground because there's going to be ruins down here, like stone ruins. So maybe they don't want it easily accessible. So just some things to think about. I built, let's see, three houses as well as a staircase, a few bridges, another platform, and grew the trees. In about, 2 hours while watching Netflix. So now here's something to think about. I started over here because let's go back into creative. And since it, that's survival. And since it doesn't really matter, let's set time set 0. If you hear me bumping into something, it's a bottle opener for work, and I just realized I keep bumping it, and it's right next to the microphone. But anyways, I started over here because one, I knew it was going to be out of the way of the build. And just think about this. I want this at least surrounding this temple all the way around. So that means that I'm going to have these buildings on all these trees all the way over here, all the way around. All the way around and possibly extending out further, and we can mix it up. We can have them where they're further apart. Here there's kind of a cluster, and I started playing with that where I didn't have this house and I had these platforms, and I was like, well, there's a tree here and it was only one tall, and I grew it again. I was like, this would give us a really cool opportunity to have a cluster of houses. So there's two right next to each other. I even thought about having a house that took up two trees, and that's another option that we'd have. And then we'll have another here. So here's a cluster of houses, maybe like a neighborhood, right? And then maybe there's a really long bridge, like from here to all the way to here or something. That'd be a crazy bridge. In fact, if there's a lot of slack on it, well, it could be tighter than these, I guess. But that's a long bridge, but that'd be, it'd be good. It's a good variety of density. Yeah, population density. That's a good word. What else? I don't know what I'm going to do with that temple. It kind of is in the way of everything. Like, it doesn't really look that great. Don't tell Mojang I don't like their builds. But, yeah, so I've decided that also it's pretty tough to go through the trees, cutting them down all at a time, and then planting them all at a time. I felt much easier just finding a tree that I wanted to build in and growing it. And now I can look at these and say, well, there's some space here. I could maybe even put a tree right here, and then there would be a tree between all of them. Maybe not. I kind of like this view that we get from here, where we can see all of them. Or, you know, over here I could have one without a house. But this way I can go by them one at a time and kind of mold the landscape to the town. And I think it's going to come out a lot better than if I were to do all of the trees and then the city. And it'll just be a lot more organized this way, because it kind of brings the city up a level above all the trees here. So I can clearly see this. If I brought everything up another level, I wouldn't be able to see this as well. And it would be a lot harder to organize. So some things to think about if you would ever think about doing something like this. I really like it, though. I've been thinking over here. I've got plans for this thing, and it's going to be pretty cool. There's going to be, like, an entrance way, right? Like a gate, sort of. Like, big grand gate. Maybe on this side, since it's on the side with the most dense and flat land. And imagine just in front of this big gate is a big platform for you to walk on with major bridges. So these, like, big beefy bridges that also sit on top of trees that aren't, like, swinging or hanging bridges. I just think it'd be a good way. It's like, in the farming village, we've talked about using different road materials, like stone, for high traffic areas. Well, that could be our high traffic areas, sort of. But anyways, guys, I like the way that this is working out. I'm actually pleasantly surprised with how easy these are to build. I mean, this much progress in a couple of hours, if I just sit down for a couple of hours each day, even if I, like, really got the urge and sat down for, like, 8 hours on a weekend or something, I could get this thing expanded out to here. And, you know, that's, if I could do that for a single episode, that's quite a bit of work if you think about it. So, easy peasy, right? Thanks for watching, everybody. If you liked it, then leave a like and subscribe. And, by the way, I do appreciate all the new subscribers that I've been getting. Thank you so much. See you next time, guys. Bye.